Hello students, I am Pitambar Gadve. In previous videos of radiation, we studied fundamental concepts of radiation, then emission characteristics of a radiation. After that, we studied laws of black body radiations. In that, we studied Planck's distribution law, Wien's displacement law, and Stefan Boltzmann law. Now, in this video, we will see radiation incident on a surface. So let us consider there is a surface. Let us consider this is a surface. Let us consider a surface, and radiation, Q amount of radiation is incident on a surface, or this Q is also called as irradiation. Radiation incident on the surface is called as irradiation. So total amount of radiation incident on a surface is Q. Now we know, so out of this Q, some amount of radiation is absorbed by the surface, which is QA. Some amount of radiation is reflected by the surface, which is denoted by QR, and some radiation is, let us say, transmitted through the surface, QT. So based on this, we have different parameters or different study, we have different terms we have to study here. So first term is total hemispherical irradiation. Total hemispherical irradiation denoted by Q. So total hemispherical irradiation. Total means at all wavelength, and hemispherical means in all directions. So the radiation coming from all directions, radiation incident on a surface in all directions with all wavelengths, that is called as Q, total hemispherical irradiation. That is nothing but radiant heat flux incident on a surface of a body in watt per meter square. This is called as irradiation or total hemispherical irradiation. Total means all wavelengths, hemispherical means in all directions, but we neglect these two terms. We are just considering irradiation. Irradiation means radiant heat flux incident on the surface of a body. So total radiation, total radiant heat flux incident on a surface is called as irradiation. Here this irradiation is denoted by Q. Now let us discuss second term, total hemispherical absorptivity. Total hemispherical absorptivity, which is denoted by alpha. So total hemispherical absorptivity, which is denoted by alpha. Here also word total and hemispherical, in general we neglect these two terms. So we call this term as irradiation, this term as absorptivity, and other like reflectivity, transmittivity. Okay, so total hemispherical absorptivity alpha is nothing but, so fraction of energy, radiant energy absorbed by the surface. So total hemispherical absorptivity means fraction of energy out of total hemispherical irradiation, fraction of energy absorbed is called as absorptivity. So we can say alpha is equal to Q total irradiation, and this QA amount of energy is absorbed by the surface. So fraction of energy out of total, so alpha is equal to QA upon Q. Let us consider this is equation number 1. So absorptivity is equal to fraction of energy absorbed out of total irradiation. Now let us move third term, total hemispherical reflectivity. Hemispherical reflectivity, total hemispherical reflectivity, and it is denoted by gamma. So total hemispherical reflectivity is denoted by gamma, and it is fraction of energy reflected. So fraction of energy reflected by the surface. So fraction of energy reflected by the surface. So we can write gamma is equal to fraction of energy reflected is QR divided by Q. Let us consider this is equation number 2. And fourth term is total hemispherical transmittivity, which is denoted by tau. Okay, so tau, total hemispherical transmittivity means radiation transmitted through the surface, radiation, fraction of radiation transmitted through the surface, which is QT upon total incident radiation, is nothing but total hemispherical transmittivity. Therefore tau is equal to QT upon Q, equation number 3. Hence we can write from equation 1, 2 and 3, we can write alpha plus gamma plus tau is equal to 1. So this is important equation, alpha plus gamma plus tau is equal to 1, and depends on the different surfaces we get this equation can be modified. So for black surface, as we know, black surface is ideal surface which absorb all the radiation falling on the surface. So for black surface, it absorb all the radiation which are incident on the surface. So for black surface, alpha is equal to 1. For black surface, alpha is equal to 1. And when alpha is 1, then gamma plus tau is equal to 0 for black surface. Now, for white surface, white surface means it reflects all the radiation. When radiation is incident on the surface, it reflects all the radiation. So gamma is equal to 1, and when gamma is 1, that means alpha plus tau is equal to 0. Now we will see for transparent surface, we have transparent surface, that means when radiation is incident on the surface, because of it is transparent, all the radiation is transmitted through the surface. So tau is equal to 1, and when tau is equal to 1, alpha plus gamma is equal to 0. And there is fourth type of surface, which is called as opaque surface is nothing but our mirror. Okay, one surface is coated and another surface is glass. So for opaque surface, tau is equal to 0, means from mirror the incident radiation, out of that total incident radiation, total irradiation, some amount of heat or energy is absorbed, whereas some amount of energy is reflected but does not transmitted to the surface. That means if does not transmitted means transmittivity is 0. So tau is equal to 0, and when tau is equal to 0, alpha plus gamma is equal to 1. So this term we have to keep in mind, what is absorptivity, transmittivity and reflectivity for all the four surfaces. Thank you.